Anthony Fasano from the Engineering Management Institute, and I'm here at the ASC SEI Structures Congress in Orlando, and I'm happy to be joined today by Kevin Lamalva from SGH. Kevin is focused in the field of structural engineering, performance-based design, which we did a whole podcast about. But right now, what I want to ask you about, Kevin, is for all engineers, regardless of their discipline, building an expertise as an engineer, a specific niche, building up some credibility can be very important to your overall success for yourself and your company. And you've done that in your field. And my question to you is, what do you recommend to engineers that are interested in developing a specific expertise? How do they start? What do they do?
Yeah, so once you sort of find a engineering discipline that you have an aspiration in, you'll find that that engineering discipline, like I am in structural engineering, will have a lot of different specialties in it. And I would recommend that you try out at least a handful of those specialties.
Sure.
And keep trying them out until you find one that really resonates with you. You know, one that has resonated with me is been fire, structural fire safety. And for a long time, I knew I wanted to be a structural engineer. However, it really took the events of 9/11 to have fire protection really begin to resonate with me. Yeah. It was something that I wasn't even planning to study before that. So if there's, you know, you have an inspiration to be in a certain area, just at least give different specialties within that discipline a try. And when you find one that, that resonates with you, really volunteer. One thing that has helped my career tremendously is basically just being the one to say, yeah, I'll do that. When we were starting to come up with ideas for standards for structural fire engineering, one of the things that I did is I said, okay, well, I'll start to write definitions because that's sort of a low-hanging fruit.
Right.
And I'm not really putting myself out there too much, and I'm just really focusing on the facts. And that sort of led one thing to the next. And I just kept volunteering. And, you know, that's really helped me in my career.
Yeah, and Kevin's been very involved with SEI, the Structural Engineers Institute from ASCE, in working on this performance-based design for fire in structural engineering. And, you know, he's probably being modest, but everyone that I was leading up to these interviews said, you got to talk to Kevin Lamalva about performance-based design. He's working on, so he's made a name for himself in that field. And it's not easy. Like you said, it's volunteering, it's working on some tedious work, but developing an expertise as an engineer can really propel you because it makes you stand out, quite frankly. And again, it can be very beneficial for your firm as well, obviously, because you're representing your firm. And also, it's also inspiring to hear Kevin talk a little bit about, you know, the events of 9/11, which were terrible, but it inspired him, which is another powerful thing about engineering, because we have the ability to help civilization effectively,
exactly.
Right? And our projects really can impact the safety of citizens. And so it's nice to know that, you know, sometimes bad things happen, but it can inspire us as engineers to then, you know, push our own limits in our careers and help civilization overall. So I hope you'll listen to what Kevin had to say. Get out there, pick a niche, try different things, volunteer in associations, on leadership boards to help you build an expertise. And not only build an expertise, but from my experience, Kevin, if it's something that you're passionate about, the more deep you get into it and you get into volunteering, you start to get into being one of the leaders in the industry, it really makes your career more enjoyable.
Exactly, and it makes it more fun. And another thing that I'll add is sometimes you may think that, okay, people have probably looked at this or have studied this, and sometimes if you're going into something unique or non-conventional, you'll just realize how few people are actually looking at it, and it just leaves a tremendous vacuum that you can, you know, make your mark on.
Great point. Yeah, don't make assumptions. If you see something that you're interested in, dive into it. Get involved and see how you can help to move it forward. All right, Kevin Lamalva from SGH, thanks again for spending some time with us here and for all of your advice. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
PPI is a proud sponsor of the Engineering Management Institute. Thinking about advancing in your career by taking your FE, PE, or SE exam? Visit ppi2pass.com to find everything you need to start preparing today.